The Parliamentary Committee of National Economy was on the floor of Parliament with a report on a proposal by government to borrow $518 million from the International Development Association of the World Bank Group and receive a grant of $48 million from the International Development Association of the World Bank Group, and also borrow up to 40 million euros from the French Development Agency to finance the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area Urban Development Program.
On national economy, on the proposal by government to borrow up to special drawing rights at 374.8 million equivalent to US dollars, at 518 million from the International Development Association, IDA, the World Bank Group, and receive a grant of special drawing rights, 34.8 million equivalent to $48 million from the International Development Association, IDA of the World Bank Group, and also borrow up to 40 million euros equivalent to $42.66 million.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, asked the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, to clarify why government continues to borrow from the World Bank despite the World Bank ban on new funding of Ugandan projects.
We saw the statement from the World Bank. Of course, I saw it in detail. By the time I put it on the order paper, I first assessed and made a judgment, but we need confirmation from you as a minister that indeed this is not one of the affected.
The assurance I want to give this House is that the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area project is not among the projects affected by the World Bank statement.
The statement was referring to new projects, so all projects which have already been approved by the World Bank, to my understanding, including some which are not yet even here, but were approved by the board, will be brought here so that we continue.
The Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area Urban Development Program comprises Kampala City and 8 metropolitan local government entities, including Entebbe, Kira, Makindye, Sabagabo, Mukono, and Nasana municipalities, as well as Mpiji and Wakiso. 550 kilometers of roads are expected to be tarmacked.
Minister of Kampala, Minister of KCCA, should ensure that the contractors chosen to carry out works under this program have a proven history of quality works to minimize on the cost of maintaining the outputs.
Legislators approved the loan, and those from Kampala metropolitan area have welcomed it and urged government to expedite its processing to save the city from traffic congestion and flooding. Parliament has also approved proposal by government to borrow funds for the refurbishment of the Kampala Malaba meter gauge railway project.
Majority of our roads are dilapidated. They have outlived the design life. And indeed, it's critical that we have our roads revamped and made good to reduce the cost of monies that we spend in jam, because overall we lose over 240,000 man hours in jam.
The issue of compensating some of the affected in these processes. Municipalities are having serious issues with this kind of Ugandans who are very serious with the law, and they are complaining they should be compensated because that's what the law says. And the town clerk will tell you, see, we don't have money at this World Bank money. They do not, it doesn't include compensation. How, as government, should we come in to make sure that as this money comes, government is ready to help?
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.